So, thank you for inviting me to explain how we implement BIM at the Schiphol Airport. I will try to be on time, okay. My introduction you already had. Thank you, Alexandra. So I will skip this one. Why do we think we need building information management at Schiphol? Internally, we are switching from BIM to asset information management because we think BIM is for the whole process. But for our asset management department, we are focusing on the maintenance part of the assets. So when it's finished and delivered to our asset management, that's where we put the most attention to, because as my friend Andrea schon erklärt had, is that most of the money goes to the life cycle after the building. Because we use our buildings about 60 years, 70 years, so yeah. So can we make better decisions during the life cycle of our assets? This is one of the things that we are questioning about at the moment. We cannot, because we have a lot of data, we have a lot of information, and a lot of assets, all kind of assets. And all the information is differently organized. We invest in these assets about investment 500, 600 million euros a year, the coming 5 years, to make our airport bigger investment. We have for maintenance costs about 150 million euros a year. And we at Schiphol think, or we are obliged, do you think, to work more efficiently, because we as an airport are in a luxury position. Airlines come and they will pay their fee. But airlines also have a lot of competition, especially the airlines in the Western Europe have big competition from the airlines from the Arabic countries. They are flying cheaper, so we have to offer our main client, KLM, EasyJet, well, all the big ones, good, efficient landing fees. So, how can we do that? Is that if we can improve the information exchange between all phases in the life cycle, we think we can work more efficiently. At the moment, a lot of parties share information on different ways. We call it, yes, we always got a nice stick. The other one says we transfer. The other one, well, just mails you still a box of paper with all the drawings, all the information. This should change if we want to make better decisions based on facts. Again, many players, a lot of assets. What we should try to do is make the data that's available for all this process, all the information exchange, analyzable. How can we make, boter van, I don't know how to say that in English, but how can we structure the information that we can make analysis, analyze it to make better decisions? How would something function? How does it do? And that's a challenge again, because now it's complex. We have a lot of information in a lot of different systems that we don't even use at the moment. We have the document management system, we have an archive still with paperwork, and luckily we are still getting more and more data through BIM. 3D data, geographical, like IFC files, with a lot of more structured data in it. At the moment, it's very time consuming to find the right data. Where's the information? We cannot answer it in 5 minutes. Probably when somebody asks us a question, can you give me all the information of the pier? It will take us 2 weeks to gather it and find it. That's why it's error sensitive. Because are we finding the right files? Also a big question. Somebody probably in his locker behind him has an updated file that we don't have in our asset management department. The project probably has more information last time we made something. So we think that we can switch from different databases, information forms, to a common data environment where all information is the single source of truth and is correct. It's a challenge because we have, well, our oldest building is from the 1965, so that's not digitized. And we improved, changed the building, well, I don't know how many times, but a lot of times. And all the information is still structured in papers, some Excel files, and some are still on the CD-ROM. So, the Opportunity Central Shared Database will be the future. And we're working on it. I'll have some example. We're almost there. Well, we hope to be there in 5 years. So there will be one central database. Oh, back too quick. where everybody can access the information, but all accessing the same database. So that all the information is one single source of truth. We don't have to go to the archive, we don't have to go to the Excel file. It's all in one common data environment, structured, organized, and always up to date. So we at Schiphol think that with asset management and BIM, we can work much more efficiently if we do this. So, I hope you're all familiar with this picture, the BIM levels, just I don't have to explain. Yeah, okay. We started that 60 years ago. The most old buildings are still in level one. A lot of drawings, digitized, but PDFs. At the moment, we are structuring that data to combine those old-fashioned PDFs to the object and the asset ID, combine them in our facility management systems. After that, now we're also making 3D models of our buildings, and that make we call that the first step to the database. So at the moment, we are nearing almost in level two. So the information is digitally linked. So we know which file is with what asset, and we can show it in a 3D model, or we can show it in our GIS system. So that's, I think, the first step, and now we can really analyze the information we have in the database of PDFs. We can find the right data quicker. At least it took us 2 or 3 weeks. Now we can deliver in 1 week. We think it's a more efficiency, first step. We want to go to level three in 2027. So it's a target that everything is digitized. There's one single source of truth and one database that everybody can enter. So, and how we want to do that is through OpenBIM. We want that all data is interpretable to every system that will be used by our advisors, our designers, our engineers, our maintenance operation. So that's why we choose for OpenBIM. Because the database, the common data environment, should be interpretable by all stakeholders that we have. And that work for us, and they can change data between the IFC structure files and BCF. So easier to exchange data. What you need for that is really, really clear agreements. So that's why the first step we did was to make an information requirements for us, employer information requirements. And we made the BIM protocol, how we should work and what kind of data should they deliver, when and how much. Because during the lifecycle, information will be added, will be rich information at the end. If you demolish, you know exactly what you don't want in your next building and what you should copy and put in your new building, because you can analyze the data. And we do that through the IFC structure. The IFC, the building standard, building smart standard, is our pillar in the database. Also, we noticed that we cannot do it by ourselves. Schiphol is a big client in the Netherlands with the airport. We have 3 airports in the Netherlands. But to make it work, we should make a Dutch standard. And we are in the bad luck that the government doesn't do it by law at the moment, like in England. So we thought we go to the second biggest client in the Netherlands, that is the government agency of real estate, and the medical universities. They are also big, complex buildings and a lot of buildings. So we are working with them now to make a Dutch employer's information requirement list. So everybody, every client that makes an order will use the same standard. And through that, we can think we can make the industry more efficiently, because we can exchange data also with each other and compare. The same thing we are trying to do with airports, because at airports, there are assets that nobody else uses. We have runway lights. I never saw them in the highway yet, but maybe in the future. But jet bridges. So that's what we want to try to put in IFC. So also we can share that data with other airports and learn from each other. So, our vision in 2027 is that we share our data. And sharing data is not only with other airports or other clients, but also share our data to our contractors. And we want information from them. We are now, I will put, come back to it later, but share them. And if we share data, we can learn from each other. And all this talking about this is also very, very important with other parties with the same problems. Because we want to go from planned maintenance to predictable maintenance. We think that we can if we can analyze our elevators the same way, because we have the same data of 220 elevators we have at the airport, and 99% of them are Kona elevators. If one breaks down, something snips, the rubber band or whatever, the open and close the door, breaks down in one lift elevator, we want to check if other, is there another elevator in the in our building with almost the same hours in use, same up and down lift, same kilo, that we should change that rubber band as well before it breaks. Because we can predict, we hope, we expect. So that will improve our efficiency. An elevator will always be functional. And that will save us money. Because we don't have downtime of our assets. So we can perform and deliver the most optimized processes for our clients, the airlines. We expect the cost reduction not to happen in the front. The design phase will probably cost us a little bit more. We expect on the design cost will rise 3%. Because we want the BIM structured, it's more effort should be put into the design phase. But we think that will be, well, realization phase, the construction phase, will save us between 10 and 20%. Because we have a digitized building that will be built. We know there are no clashes. We know that it can be made because everything is 3D geographically matched. And we know the data. And in maintenance, the cost reduction we expect is about 5% to 8%. So if you fix those two figures, 10 to 15% on construction at 500 million to 600 million a year, then BIM to implement asset information management is a laugh. Because we expect it will cost us for the next 20 years, till 2027, it will cost us 20 million. But if we can save these figures that the market is telling us and what we are already seeing, it's nothing. So, shamefully, this is in Dutch because it was not in English yet. This is how we want to do it. In the middle, a central database with all information accessible through every device you can think of. I can show you straight on my mobile phone, yet we can walk through the building. Partners will talk to the open standards. They will update it. This we can analyze with all kind of different tooling that will be developed in the market. Everything is 3D accessible to the main contractors. Our smart asset will measure as well. The small chip that Andreas showed us, we are putting that at the moment, it's a good example, on our pathways, the electrical pathways. Is that the correct word? We can measure the temperature of the engine. And we measure as well the electricity. So now we can combine them and see if the temperature goes up and the electricity goes up, probably something will break down in a few minutes or the next day. So now we can send a maintenance guy to look at it. Why? What is happening? Is it too dusty? Is there something wrong? So we predict already. Some use cases. One of the piers of Schiphol, the G pier, has an extra layer on top of it. It was delivered to us 2 years ago already. And 4 years ago, we had to decide, are we going to do it in BIM or are we going to do it in the traditional way? The project management team chose for 2D, the traditional way. At the end, we had asset management, got our 2D revision, and we thought, okay, let's see, let's make it the S-built drawings. Let's make it a 3D model for us so we can test it. There were 650 clashes in the S-built drawings. If you look at it, that all those problems were solved on site. So if you look at it, well, how much is this? €1,000 lost a day because he had wrong materials, had to go back to his supervisor to explain, hey, this didn't work. What should I do? A half a day is lost. So in total, we think, no, it's almost €1 million, €650,000. And the extra cost to design it in BIM was €50,000. And we decided, oh, that's too much money. We didn't budget it. Afterwards, okay. So what you all will see here is that we think, that's what we notice at the moment, the hours of work are shifting more to the front. The design phase is becoming more important. Our new KLM Crown Lounge, the bigger business class lounge, is being updated at the moment. We had a design in BIM, the whole design. We scanned the whole building, we put a revision, Indeed. We won the prize in 2016 for BIM model at the Building Smart Convention, the summit in Korea. The contractor party is also doing everything in BIM. We share the information to a digital database in the cloud. So all our supervisors can look in the model. What we learned about this is that you have to make clear agreements because design went good, engineering went good. And then we handed over to the construction company. Well, we didn't really have good agreements in what should the engineers deliver to the contracting party. So we had 2 weeks or 3 weeks lost to get all the right information to the next party, the next stakeholder in the design process. So the next time we'll do it better, and now we have clear agreements with the engineers what they should deliver to the contracting party. And they're now at the moment in construction. Then we have departure hall one. We are growing faster than we had anticipated the last 3-4 years, so we needed an extra space to check in and deliver. We had the calculation, we had only 7 months to realize it. It wasn't time, they did it in 7 months, our contractors. But it took 2 months in design, but did it in BIM. So they were sure that on site there were no clashes. So to get constructed in 5 months. What we all next to that is validation. Was it built the way we decided with each other? So we, after it was finished, we made a scan and we compared it to the IFC model that we agreed on that was built. One of the things we noticed there was that the ceiling was higher than expected. We realized, well, the plan of the ceiling should be lower. Okay, luckily this other way around, it should be lower than the design was a problem, but this way it went okay. But we compared it, so we asked them to do a scan, nobody was there, and we could compare if they had made what we ordered. And this took 4 hours to make the scan. If you walk around, it will take you a whole day, minimum. But okay, also here you can learn. Because we had so little time, we didn't make clear agreements what information should be in the model. We didn't give our employees information requirements because they had no time, just run. So what was the delay here was to give the data to our facility management system. The BIM model was not suitable, so we had to update it. And update afterwards is much more complex than do it the right way from start. It took us a month, but now we can use it because now we have the validated information we can import straight to facility management systems. And with that kind of information, you can link the boat again. So what we do now, the left you see the information and the right the model, because we know what data we measure, we know what data we question. If the elevator stops working, we can see if there's a person in there or not because we measure the mate. So we can now determine if we should send somebody to help the elevator, there's somebody in the elevator, so there's emergency, real emergency, or no, it is just broken down, nobody has to run because the elevator, nobody's inside. So we can more efficiently coordinate our maintenance people. Normally, when this used to happen a year ago, everybody should stop doing what they're working because some elevators stop, they had to run to the office, see what elevator it is, and run to the site. Now we just send an email, okay, this elevator is broken down, no rush, no people inside, but please attend to it when you finish your job you're doing now. So that's also more efficiently. One of the other things we do now is behind the screen, we can have the link. Sadly, it doesn't work live, but I can show you after in the coffee break. In our Maximal system, there's a link you can click on, and then you go to the point cloud we use to validate. So if there's a maintenance issue with the air handling unit you see in the picture to the right, there's a spot on it. He can click on it. From there on, he can walk through the technical room, see how wide, what kind of, do I need a ladder? Do I need something else? What equipment should I bring? And he can see the data, because all information is behind that sheet. Also, the guarantees, handlining. What's handlining? Okay. What we never read when we use to install our video or TV or start up the computer. It's all behind that link. But he can also, from this 360 picture, he can say, I'm here in the Schiphol building. What is my most efficient way to get there? He will get a map in his phone, so he can walk from his office to the asset he has to repair. So, what we say, Open BIM, IFC, BCF works. We are trying and we're exploring, we're learning by doing, but it's working, and we have good results. But what's very important, you need clear agreements. If you don't make them before you start a project, it's gonna fail. Or it will cost you a lot of extra time to update the information. And working together is essential. Be open through the whole project life of the asset. When you design, make sure they are open. They share the information they have. They share every day if you can. So everybody sees the latest information. And that's what we're working out to put all, they always have to work from a common data environment of Schiphol. So all engineers, all parties are working through our databases. So we know before they go home at 5 o'clock each day what they have done and what the information has changed. And we know that the next day, all engineers will start with the same information, more efficiently. The quality of the employer's information requirements is essential. Know what kind of information you need to maintain your building. Find out. Ask every maintenance guy you have in your office, what do you need, why, and what. And then you should check on it. Everyone who works for you should be compliant to that information requirements. And they should always do it. And what you said here, almost good, is not good enough, is fatal. And what we see also, the technologies are developing so rapidly and they're so usable. The point cloud scanning, that we don't have to send anybody before the ceiling closes, that they make a scan, we know that all the insulation above the ceiling are there. We can check it, and if something breaks down, they can see it with a real picture where it is and what it is. Very important. So, I think, that's why she will join us. We need to collaborate to get BIM moving and get BIM more accepted for all building industry and asset life management. So, it's based on managed exchange from reality says here. That was it. No more questions, any questions, let's put it that way. No? Don't finish.
Many best thanks, Mr. Warp.